Hello and welcome. I'm James Murphy, and today I'm going to show you why every proof that you've seen of the fact that 0.99 repeating equals 1 is wrong. Don't worry, it is true. This isn't one of those videos. It's just the proofs that you've seen that are wrong. So first, I'll show you why those other proofs are wrong, and then I'll show you my actual proof. The vast majority of proofs that 0.99 repeating equals 1 are so-called algebraic proofs. They start with some number, they do some algebraic manipulations, and then they somehow derive that 1 is equal to 0.99 repeating from that. These are by far the most common kind of proof that you'll see when you look it up. And at a first glance, they look pretty sensible. I start with x being 0.99 repeating, then I multiply by 10, I subtract x, and then I solve for x equals 1. Seems valid, right? We all know a third is 0.33 repeating, multiply by 3, and then we get 1 is 0.99 repeating, right? Well, it turns out there are multiple mistakes in these proofs. Well, right at the very start, we've actually made a huge mistake. Just by writing 0.99 repeating, I'm implicitly assuming that it exists. If 0.99 repeating didn't exist, then I wouldn't be able to multiply by 10 and then solve for it. This is the error that pretty much every video makes. I've only seen one that doesn't make this mistake. Let me show you what can go wrong in a very similar situation by making this assumption that it does exist. Instead of looking at 0.99 repeating, let's look at a very similar expression. Let's suppose that a number 9 repeating and then the point exists. So I'm thinking here as the decimal point with 9s extending out on the left side of it instead of on the right side of it. I start with 9 repeating, I multiply by 10, I add 9, and I see that I end up back with the number that I started with. So then I can solve for that algebraically, and I get that x is minus 1. Pause the video and check the steps if you want. So do you believe that 9 repeating point is equal to negative 1? Well, no, you really shouldn't. There are number systems where this kind of thing is true, but the real numbers is not one of them. Okay, so suppose you're willing to believe that it does exist as a real number, then the rest of the proof works, right? Well, still no. So what's wrong? Is it one of the highlighted green statements? Which one of those is wrong? Well, none of them. All of those statements are true. They're true because 0.99 repeating is equal to 1, but these proofs don't show it. You have to keep in mind that a proof of something is not simply a list of true statements that ends in the one that you're looking for. I can't just say 1 plus 1 equals 2, 2 plus 2 equals 4, the fundamental theorem of calculus holds. These are all true statements, but this is not a proof of the fundamental theorem of calculus. You need to show why each step implies the next. Since the rules of algebra are so well known, in algebraic proofs, it's very common to leave off this reasoning. But for now, let me make those implications explicit. So in this slide, I'm using this implies arrow to indicate that each line implies the next line. I claim that the issue with these proofs lies in these arrows, not in the statements themselves. These red arrows specifically. Look at the first step on the left. I multiply 0.99 repeating by 10, and I end up with 9.99 repeating. Now, for ordinary finite decimal expansion numbers, we know that multiplying by 10 is the same as just moving the decimal point one to the right. But how do we know that that holds for repeated decimals? After all, you could never finish the computation of multiplying it out. Now again, this is true. You are allowed to do this, but we haven't justified why in this proof. The reason that you're allowed to is actually a fact from calculus, not algebra. Now, while this step is fine if you're familiar with calculus, it's essentially just pushing a constant inside a limit, the general population that would be interested in answering this question, is 0.99 repeating equal to 1, we can't assume that they know that. If we just use that fact, I think we're kind of doing them a disservice because it doesn't really answer their question. All we've really done is hidden the details in another thing that they don't understand. The problem with the red arrow on the right is pretty similar. How do I know that multiplying 0.33 repeating times 3 actually gives 0.99 repeating? And as long as we're on the topic of hiding details in places you don't understand, why are you so okay with 1/3 being exactly equal to 0.33 repeating? That sounds kind of just as hard to prove as 0.99 repeating is equal to 1. People seem a lot more okay with that one, but I don't really think you should be. Okay, let's start working towards an actual proof. First, let's address what I think is the real source of your confusion, the definition of 0.99 repeating. What does 0.99 repeating actually mean? It is definitely not some kind of mystical number with infinitely many nines after the decimal point. That's not a definition. You have to give a definition in terms of things that are already understood. So here's how we actually define 0.99 repeating. We start by defining a sequence. The first element of the sequence is 0.9, then 0.99, then 0.999, and so on, where the nth term in the sequence is just point followed by n nines. You can write it for an arbitrary n using this capital sigma fancy math notation, but that's not really necessary. Remember that for a fixed value of n, this is just a finite decimal approximation. It has n digits after the decimal point, and it stops. The definition of 0.99 repeating is just the number that this sequence approaches, if there is such a number. In mathematical terms, we say that it is the limit of the sequence, but it's okay if you're not familiar with limits. Just think it's the number that this sequence approaches. So let's get back to the original question. What is 0.99 repeating equals 1 even claiming? All it's saying is that this sequence 0.9, 0.99, 0.999, and so on is approaching a real number, and that number is 1. Well, isn't that obvious? You already knew that. Here's a plot of the first few terms of the sequence. You can see that it's definitely going to 1 pretty quickly. So at this point, do I even really need to give a proof? Now that you understand what this statement is actually claiming, it doesn't seem so mystical anymore, does it? What it's actually claiming is just pretty mundane. But I did say that I will give a real proof, so here it is. All we have to show is that that sequence of 0.9999 approximations is getting closer and closer to 1. Okay, so let's just look at the difference, xn minus 1 in absolute value. Plug in the expression for xn, and you see that that difference is 10 to the minus n, or 1 over 10 to the n if you prefer. I think a lot of people would be comfortable stopping there and saying, okay, yeah, I see that this goes to 0. But if you really want to finish the argument and give the formal definition, then okay, give me some tolerance epsilon bigger than 0. Then I say, well, for any n that's bigger than 1 over epsilon, we see that that difference is 10 to the minus n, which is less than 1 over n, which is less than epsilon. And that's how you would formally show that the sequence approaches 1. But of course, you already knew that. So I hope that really clears things up for you so you don't have that irky feeling in your stomach when you see one of those algebraic proofs and still don't really feel satisfied with the conclusion. All the real hard work is just in understanding the definition, and once you understand that, I think it clears right up. And I do want to address one last thing. I know that a lot of videos phrase this as a choice. What should we choose 0.99 repeating to be? And that is completely fair. You can take the symbols and define them to mean whatever you want. But notice that this whole process of defining a repeating decimal didn't really depend on using 0.99. The real choice here that mathematicians made was not that 0.99 repeating equals 1. The actual thing that mathematicians decided on was, what does it mean to add up an infinite number of things? So in that sense, we didn't choose the value of 0.99 repeating to be 1. We chose the definition of an infinite sum, and then from that we were able to derive the value of 0.99 repeating. And the last thing that I want to talk about is all those other videos. Now, if you just looked at the title of this video, you might think I'm trying to start some kind of flame war, which I'm definitely not. I think that each of those videos is worth watching, and you can learn something from each and every one of them. I just felt like none of those videos really fully removed the source of confusion. So that's the real reason that I wanted to make this video, just to clear things up for you, the viewer. I do want to give a special shout out to the Mathematical Association of America. Their video was the only one that I found that didn't assume that 0.99 repeating exists. And I stole one of the examples in this video from theirs.
Hey everyone, that's all I've got on this topic, so thank you for watching. If you liked the video, please consider subscribing, sharing with your friends, and as always, slap that like button an odd number of times. See you next time.